if you've taken a while to respond, this is the one that I absolutely love. When people contact me, right, and maybe they're late, maybe I've reached out to them and now it's 5, 6, 10, 2 weeks later, and they contact you and here's what they say, I've been busy. As if for some reason the fact that they're busy exonerates them from proper business behavior.
Assuming they are.
Assuming they are, sure, right? Here's the reality. Busy is what you want, right? You know what non-busy salespeople do? Starve, right? Do you know what busy salespeople do? Eat steak, but you know what they also do? Don't use it as an excuse. I had a mentor of mine, Ike, back in Michigan. And he said, you're either going to find an excuse or you're going to find a way. You get to choose. You're going to find an excuse, you're going to find a way, right? The idea of being busy does not exonerate you from proper business behavior. In fact, business behavior, the idea of being busy is what you want. Because I will frequently tell people, they'll say, well, geez, Don, I'm so busy, I'm working 60 hours a week and blah, 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 blah. And I'll say, good, well, when do you want to talk about that problem? And in their mind, they don't see themselves having a problem. They think being busy is the activity. And I think to myself, well, if we're going to double, triple your business and you're already working 60 hours a week, well, we're not going to have you work 120 hours a week. That doesn't make any sense. Being busy is meaningless. Making money, performance, as John indicated, that's the meaningful. If you've taken a while to respond, be penitent. Bob, I have no excuse for my poor behavior. Don't blow smoke at me. Don't tell me you're busy, right? We all have emergencies. We all have families. We all have crises. We all have problems. That does not exonerate bad behavior. You could say with a simple phone call, right, because it's emotional, Bob, I've had a death in my family. Can I reach out to you next week, right? I can't imagine Bob saying, no, you can't. We got it. No, of course not. People are people. When you connect with them on an emotional level, you know what they're going to say? Oh, my God, I'm so sorry to hear that, right? I'll say a prayer for you. No problem. We'll talk next week, right? If it is that compelling, fine, then figure out a way to have somebody else follow up on it. But when you've taken a while to respond, nothing is even more insulting on top of that is to get the text and say, I'm sorry I've been so busy, right? Talk about just devaluating the relationship. I mean, so many people shoot themselves in their own foot because they don't do the minimum amount they need to just maintain the relationship. So you call as opposed to email or text when you believe that you have questions. Number two, you're going to have an emotional conversation or somehow emotion's going to kick in, or if you've taken a while to respond. Now, again, that's probably going to be about 95% of your calls.